Melly.
Ja.
Sierra and Brandon in holy matrimony. This day is a great celebration and reverence on which we come together before family and friends to recognize and commemorate the sacred love and dedication shared between these two people. It's wonderful to have family and friends here to join us today. The bride and groom would like to thank their guests for being here and would like you to know that each of you were invited here on this day because you played an integral part in their intertwining lives. As the Bible reminds us in Corinthians, love is patient, love is kind. It does not envy, it does not boast. It is not proud, it is not rude. It is not self-seeking, it is not easily angered. It keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth it always protects. Always trusts, always hopes, always preserves, love never fails. In the time that Brandon and Sierra have spent together since June of 2011, they've built a sturdy foundation for a lifelong relationship. After a great deal of thoughtful consideration, they have decided to bind themselves to one another for the rest of their lives. May you all remember and cherish the sacred ceremony. For this day with love, we will forever bind Sierra and Brandon together. Who gives this bride today?
Our mother and I.
Is there anyone in attendance who has cause to believe that this couple should not be joined in marriage? You may speak now or forever hold your peace. Marriage is a sacred ceremony. Today we observe the union of these two people with the respect the occasion warrants. What we honor with reverence, however, we also celebrate with great joy. For married life, a shared life is a tremendous blessing. Now as Sierra and Brandon embark on their journey together, they will be able to nurture a love that makes each of them better versions of themselves. Marriage is indeed the perfect garden from which to sow and harvest personal growth. Sierra and Brandon have chosen a reading that they feel describes their love towards each other. They'd like me to read that for them. A good marriage must be created. In marriage, the little things are the big things. It is never being too old to hold hands. It is remembering to say I love you at least once a day. It is never going to sleep angry. It is having a mutual sense of values and common objectives. It is standing together and facing the world. It is a circle, forming a circle that gathers in the whole family. It is speaking words of appreciation and demonstrating gratitude in thoughtfulness ways. It is having the capacity to forgive and forget. It is giving each other an atmosphere in which each can grow. It is a common search for the good and beautiful. It is not only marrying the right person, it is being the right partner. Sierra and Brandon, learn to work together, to laugh together, and to love together. Don't get caught up in worldly things that will draw you apart. Instead, focus on your shared devotion and turn inward. As your relationship strengthens, you will find that you come to share a remarkable love, a love that is both abundantly given and freely accepted. The joy you'll find as you pursue your shared lives will fuel you to face head-on challenges you'll encounter on this earth. On your journeys together, keep your spouse in the space of highest priority. In your heart, the love you share must be guarded and cherished. It is your most valuable treasure. Under the eyes of family and friends, I solemnly consecrate these marital proceedings for the sacred covenant, and you shall both enter into this day. Marriage is an ancient rite. As you enter into this union, you are choosing to take part in historical human establishment and are pledging your commitment before the witnesses present here today to enter into the tradition with honor. Brandon and Sierra, please face one another. I believe you guys wanted to do your own vows.
She wrote a book. Brandon's got a little one-liner.
Today I vow to always be honest with you, patient with you, and forgiving towards you. I promise to be your lover and best friend, and when the time comes, your partner in parenthood. I promise to always be by your side when life tries to knock you down, because together we can get through anything. I promise to forever be there to laugh with you, cry with you, and to make memories with you. I promise to be your biggest supporter. But I also promise to let you know you're needed at last.
You're here.
When I say I love you more, I don't mean that I love you more than you love me. I mean that I love you more than bad days ahead of us. I love you more than any obstacle that could test our relationship. And I love you more than any argument you will ever have. In the past 5.5 years, we have gone through a lot of rough patches. But with each other's love and advice and encouragement, we've made it through to a better day. I'm eager to see where we will go in life and how much we will experience together, the many more memories that we will have, and where we will end up. I used to be afraid to experience life alone, and I don't have to found my forever partner. Here's to the beginning of the rest of our lives, and I love you.
On this day, I vow in front of our family and friends to make this lifetime commitment. All those years ago, we were just kids looking for a good time. It never crossed my mind at 17 I'd bump into the lady I was going to marry. I was going to spend the rest of my life with. As time passed, I began to fall in love with you. This relationship has been tested time and time again without a doubt. Our love is strong. You've seen me at my worst and stuck on my side. I've gone through the hardest obstacles I've ever had to face with you. And early on, I realized that you were my rock, my support, my anchor to keep me grounded. I'm proud to call you my wife. My love, my best friend forever. And with this vow, I promise to always protect you, be faithful and trustworthy, support your wishes and dreams, and make you feel beautiful and loved every day until I take my last breath. I promise to be a caring, loving husband, and hopefully, one day, a father. And without a doubt, you're going to be an amazing mother, trusting to children. Whatever the future may bring, I'm glad I get to spend the time.
All right. Okay, we'll now do the official exchanging of the vows. Sierra and Brandon, the sacred vows. that you make one another today present you with the opportunity to express your love in your own words. I would at this time like you to invite you to publicly declare these vows. Sierra, you may begin. So repeat after me. I, Sierra, take you, Brandon, for my lawfully wedded husband.
I, Sierra, take you, Brandon, for my lawfully wedded husband.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
For better or worse, for richer or poor.
For better or for worse.
I promise to be true to you in good times and bad. In sickness and in health. I will love you and honor you all the days of my life. Until death do us part. This is my solemn vow. Brandon, you may now make your promise. I, Brandon, take you, Sierra, for my lawfully wedded wife.
I, Brandon, take you, Sierra, for my lawfully wedded wife.
To have and to hold from this day forward. For better or worse, for richer or poor. I promise to be true to you in good times and bad. In sickness and in health. I will love you and honor you all of the days of my life. Until death do us part. This is all well. Sierra and Brandon, under the eyes of family and friends, Sierra, do you take Brandon to be your lawfully wedded husband? By making this commitment, you are joining in the sacred covenant of marriage.
I do.
Yes.
I do.
Brandon, under the eyes of family and friends, do you take Sierra to be your lawfully wedded wife? By making this commitment, you're joining the covenant of marriage.
I do.
Okay, to commemorate this union, you may now exchange rings. The circle formed by each ring symbolizes your internal love and commitment to one another. Let these rings remind you always that you love and the promise you give made on this day. But you each... please repeat after me as you place the ring on your loved one's hand. Sierra, I give you Brandon this ring as a symbol of my love and commitment.
I give you Brandon this ring as a symbol of my love and commitment.
With this ring, I thee wed.
With this ring, I thee wed.
Don't try to jump. Brandon, can't jump.
Brandon, give you Sierra this ring as a symbol of my love and commitment. With this ring, I thee wed.
With this ring, I thee wed.
By the power invested in me, by the Universal Life Church in the state of California, I pronounce you Sierra and Brandon as husband and wife, lawfully wedded before God. Brandon, you may now kiss the bride, forever sealing your union.
Oh.
Present you Mr. and Mrs. Brandon Shepherd.
Watching.